Disclaimer, this video will contain spoilers for the Attack on Titan ending. I don't know if that was already obvious enough. If you're a manga reader who hasn't caught up with the ending yet, I suggest you go do it now. If you're an anime-only watcher, I don't get why you're watching this video. I don't know why you'd spoil it for yourself, but I mean, whatever, you do you. But yeah, anyway, that's all I gotta say. Please enjoy the video. Hi! The Attack on Titan ending happened, and
why did my fix that? Oh my god, why has it sunk my ass?
Sunk my ass.
I ordered my body pillow from Isayama. 5 weeks ago.
Isayama.
Why does it have my design and look together? I ordered my shit. This is so hard.
Why?
Did I like the ending? Well, yes and no. On one hand, I'm relieved that for the most part, I now don't have to worry about adding the Attack on Titan ending to the reasons why I'm in therapy. But nevertheless, I think we can all agree that the ending being happy was probably one of the most unexpected endings, because it was actually happy. Maybe, I'm not really sure, maybe it's just me. Cause, okay, if you really think about it, after suffering through the trauma of chapter 138, which, by the way, what the fuck? What the fuck? What the fuck? I think we all had built up ideas that the final chapter would leave us crying on the floor for our mommy, but instead, we actually got a pretty happy ending. I mean, Eren is dead and Mikasa is alone, heartbroken, but yeah, I'd say it was pretty happy. But if you really want to talk about the greatest tragedy in the series, it's obviously Reiner not being able to smash his story's wall, if you know what I mean. But like, bro, really, handwriting? Is that a kink in the AOT universe, the smell of handwriting? You know, I'm not gonna get into it. However, at least Falco gets with Gabby. Also, did Levi ever get to open his tea shop? Because if he didn't, we're gonna have some issues, Isayama. However, thinking back to the first chapter of Attack on Titan, it's extremely impressive how this was all foreshadowed all the way from the beginning of the first chapter and also ending in the same spot it began, which was a really touching detail from Isayama. Along with the bird wrapping the scarf around Mikasa's neck being hinted at being Eren's reincarnation, which, I mean, birds have been a reoccurring image or symbol throughout the series representing the freedom, like the wings of freedom from the Survey Corps, the one scene where Falco was on the battlefield warning the bird to fly far away, etc. My personal favorite scene from the chapter, however, which I think most people can agree with, was when Levi got to see all his dead comrades and we finally got to see him shed a tear. In my opinion, it was a really beautiful and touching scene, and it really was probably one of my favorites from the entirety of the series. Now, moving on to things I did not like about the ending.
Cartman, what do you mean thank you for committing mass murder? It's genocide!
Anyway, we're gonna take a quick break from talking about the manga for a second, and I wanted to talk a bit about what I'm doing in the painting so far. So as you can see, right now I'm just doing the base colors for the face. If you don't know, I am not really that much of an experienced painter. I've only done a couple painting pieces in my lifetime. I used to focus more using acrylics because they are a lot simpler. However, I've been trying to use oil paints more because I thought it'd be good to expand my skill set. And as you can see, I'm trying to learn how to like blend out the colors a bit, trying to put down the shade, like the shaded areas for the nose and the eyebrows and stuff like that. However, I am hoping that this will, or in this point in time in the painting, I was hoping things would turn out well, which I mean, in the end it does. However, I'm not really the best at realistic style portraits, so I used a couple of references of male German models and of course, you know, Eren from the manga to try and capture the essence. However, there's still a very like anime look to the painting because like, you like once you see the finished like product, I guess at towards the end you'll see that it isn't like 100% realistic. There is still that like semi unrealistic, you know, type of look to it because like you'll get what I mean. But anyway, back to talking about how I don't really like the ending in certain ways. Okay, thing is, I get what Isayama was trying to pull. Like he was trying to give like a Lelouch type of ending where Eren will shoulder the blame and sins all on his back so that they can get peace. But I feel like it could have been a lot more fleshed out since it all seemed a bit rushed. Like if it went on for maybe 2 or 3 more chapters, Isayama could have made it all a bit more
Like, it could have made a lot more sense, and there wouldn't have been as many plot holes as the actual final chapter had. And it could have given, like, more background and context, because, like, I was really liking Hitler 2.0. I'm joking. But in all seriousness, if Eren just became a slave to fate and went through with the rumbling completely, to me it would have been way more impactful and shows the cycle of hate finally ending only when it reaches the point of destruction. However, and it would have driven home the manga's message in a way, showing how hate would never lead to anything good but destruction and ultimately death. And in my opinion, it would have suited the darker tone of the rest of the series that it had up to that point. I also had problems with Eren's characters, where I can see why Eren all of a sudden started acting like a simp, because he's still technically a teenager, but it was too sudden of a change for me from his cold demeanor from like the past couple chapters and going on after the time skip and all that type of stuff. I get that it was supposed to show that he was still human and still a kid, but it fell flat for me because he could have given more hints. He would have made more sense to me because he goes from "I hate you, Mikasa" to "please don't leave me, please don't love someone else," like, within like a chapter. And to me, it was just really out of character from the current Eren that we know compared to the beginning. If it was like him during the beginning, it would have made more sense for his character, but obviously since he's progressed so much throughout the series, to me it wasn't really a fitting for his like current character. I can understand the arguments that other people say that it did fit him, and I could see why, but personally for me, it just didn't really fit that well. Another thing that bothered me was Ymir and why she was the way she was, being that she was in love with King Fritz, which, I mean, Stockholm Syndrome, but it just left a weird taste in my mouth. That's like, that's why she's so like glued, or that's, I don't know, it's just I remember seeing this one video where it talks about how instead of her being in love with King Fritz, she had some sort of like Ackerman like bond, which made her how she was, and she made just like dedicated herself to him, which would have made a lot more sense to me than just her being like, "Oh, I was in love with King Fritz, my abuser." But yeah, it was just weird because like at this point, Attack on Titan low-key just turned into a romance manga, and I was just like, what is happening? If I can find the video that talks about it a bit more in depth, I'll definitely link it down below though. The last qualm I kind of have with the final chapter, but it doesn't really have to do with the chapter itself or Isayama, but more so the fandom of Attack on Titan in the current like state of the anime fandoms. I remember that Isayama intended on having a way darker ending, which I honestly would have preferred and liked way better, because personally I've always been a fan of darker anime. I like Madoka Magica, Neon Genesis, Cowboy Bebop, like, you know, like, or Berserk, like all these like anime with like super dark themes and like endings, and I really enjoyed that type of stuff. So for me, like, this is just all my opinion, my personal taste, but I would have preferred a darker ending. But I honestly understood why Isayama had to change his ending from his initial one, because I know some people are theorizing that Isayama might release another Attack on Titan like alternate ending that will like give the fans who wanted a darker ending like, oh, here's the darker one, and it'd be the true ending. But I highly doubt that would happen. I wouldn't put it past Isayama if he released like an alternate ending to the series, because he is a mad lad. However, I can understand completely why he made the ending a lot more happier than he initially planned, considering the increased popularity of Attack on Titan over the past couple years. And for my own theory is that, you know, due to like, if you really look at the state of like anime fandom right now, it's super sensitive. Like, they're all super sensitive to anything they slightly disagree with or things that they don't go the way they want. So making a happier ending would have been the more acceptable and safer bet. Like, I know fans like me would still be disappointed, but it goes to show you can never please everyone. However, it really sucks that nowadays a lot of creators have to adjust their works because of the fandom to avoid backlash. Like, for example, My Hero, which I don't want to get into. That fandom is a fucking ticking time bomb. It's going to explode at one point. I honestly feel so bad for the creator. But yeah, I think people should just accept the endings for how they are and just take it as face value. I didn't hate the ending. I didn't love the ending. It's just an ending. It like fit the story as it was. It didn't like ruin it for me. I think it's satisfying enough for me that I just enjoyed it. So all in all, I really do think I really do thank Isayama for the 12 long years he put into crafting and making Attack on Titan. It is a beautifully written story with a memorable and lovable cast and played a huge role in my childhood up until now. And it is one of my inspirations, and I can't wait to see what you'll do next.
Isayama-san, 모든 크라스코 작성 시마스타 本当に ありがとうございます. Shinzo, sasagaeyo. But I think Eren looks pretty sexy here in my opinion. Anyway, that's all I really gotta say. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment. And if you don't,
I will commit arson. Alright, bye-bye.